Hello viewers, in the previous episode we have discussed about the preparation of final accounts for the profit making, that is trading organizations. However, there are some concerns which do not do the activity of trading. The objective of these organizations is to render services to the society without any intentions of earning profits. In this episode, we will be discussing on the characteristics of non-trading concerns, different accounts to be maintained by them, etc. For our study, this episode is divided into 5 parts, namely, meaning of non-trading concerns, characteristics of non-trading concerns, accounts to be maintained by non-trading concerns, classification of capital items and revenue items, and important items in non-profit making or non-trading concern. The Institute of Chartered Accountants of India has termed a non-trading concern as a legal and accounting entity that is operated for the benefit of the society as a whole rather than for the benefit of a sole proprietor or a group of partners or shareholders. Profit-making concerns prepare final accounts to ascertain the profitability and financial position of their business for an accounting period. But non-trading concerns, also known as non-profit making organizations, intends to serve the society. These organizations can be broadly classified into 3 categories, namely, organizations for general welfare of their members such as clubs, associations, welfare institutions, etc. Charitable organizations such as educational institutions, hospitals, etc. Professional firms such as chartered accountants, tax consultants, advocate firms, doctors, etc. The above mentioned organizations are called non-trading concerns because they do not have to purchase or sell goods either for cash or on credit or receive or issue bills of exchange. The main characteristics of non-trading concerns are, number 1, non-trading concerns are formed to provide service either free of cost or at nominal cost to a specific group or public at large, such as recreation clubs, sports clubs, educational institutions, health clubs, and so on, and not to earn profit. Number 2, they do not usually enter into credit transactions. Number 3, non-trading concerns are organized as charitable trusts or societies, and subscribers to such organizations are called members. Number 4, there will be a managing or executive committee elected by its members for managing the affairs of these concerns. Number 5, the main sources of income of such concerns are the subscriptions from members, donations, legacies, government grants and other grants, income from investments, etc. Number 6, they prepare a summary of cash book called receipts and payments account. Number 7, non-profit making organizations do not prepare trading and profit and loss account. Instead, they prepare an income and expenditure account. Number 8, the accounting information provided by such organization is meant for the present and potential contributors and to meet the statutory requirement. Number 9, non-profit making organizations do not have capital, they have capital fund. Necessity of maintaining accounts. Though non-trading concerns do not have the intentions of making profit, still they need to maintain certain accounts like the trading organizations, since most of their transactions involve cash. So, they maintain cash books and a minimum number of other books which may be required for their purposes. The following points clearly explain why a non-trading concern should maintain accounts. A. To know whether funds are being used appropriately. B. To avoid or at least reduce the possibility of misappropriation and frauds by the office bearers. C. To prevent the frauds that may happen when there is no proper accounting system. D. To show the result of activities and progress of the organization. E. To know the availability of cash so that the future activities can be properly planned. F. To know the financial position of the concern for the benefit of the members. At the end of each accounting period, a non-trading concern also prepares its final accounts, which includes a receipts and payments account, an income and expenditure account, and a balance sheet. Let us discuss one by one. Number one, receipts and payments account. Receipts and payments account is merely a summary of cash transactions under proper heads which have taken place during the accounting period. This account is prepared on the basis of real accounting rule. It is a summary of all cash receipts like subscriptions received, interest received and other receipts of cash, etc. and payments which includes salaries, rent, honorarium, etc. made during the year. Here, there is no distinction between capital and revenue items. This account does not show any surplus or deficit. The main features of receipts and payments account are: receipts and payments account is an abbreviated copy of cash book. Receipts and payments account is not a part of double entry bookkeeping. It is just a summary of cash book, which is a part of double entry system. It records all cash receipts and payments irrespective of the year for which such receipts and payments belong to. It starts with the balance in the beginning of the accounting year and ends with the balance at the end of the accounting year. Income and expenditure account. Income and expenditure account is similar to that of a profit and loss account prepared by the trading concerns, and this account performs the same functions and is compiled and constructed precisely on the nominal accounting rule. This account is prepared to show the expenditure and incomes of current period only. This account shows surplus or deficit. The main features of income and expenditure account are: income and expenditure account is similar to the profit and loss account of trading concerns. Only expenditure and incomes of current year is recorded. The balance of this account represents either a surplus, that is excess of income over expenditure, or a deficit, that is excess of expenditure over income. The difference, either a surplus or deficit, obtained in income and expenditure account will be transferred to the balance sheet. Let us now differentiate between receipts and payments account and income and expenditure account. Receipts and payments account is a real account, whereas income and expenditure account is a nominal account. Receipts and payments account is a summary of all cash receipts and payments during the year, whereas income and expenditure account is a summary of expenditure and incomes of current period only. In case of receipts and payments account, there is no distinction between capital and revenue items, whereas in case of income and expenditure account, only revenue items of current year are taken into account. In receipts and payments account, all cash receipts are recorded on the debit side and payments on the credit side. Whereas in income and expenditure account, expenses are recorded on the debit side and incomes on the credit side. In receipts and payments account, outstanding expenses and outstanding incomes are excluded, whereas in income and expenditure account, outstanding expenses and outstanding incomes are considered. In receipts and payments account, this account does not show any surplus or deficit, whereas income and expenditure account shows surplus or deficit. Balance sheet. In case of a non-trading concern, a balance sheet is prepared at the end of accounting year in the usual manner and contains particulars of all the assets and liabilities of the organization on the date on which it was prepared. The excess of assets over liabilities are termed as capital fund. Capital fund is made up of excess of income over expenditure and other income or surplus which might have been capitalized by the institution from time to time. Sometimes there are situations where two balance sheets have to be prepared. One, at the beginning of the accounting year to ascertain the amount of capital fund at the beginning of the year, and at the end of the accounting year to show the financial position of the concern as on that date. Capital items. Capital items are those which are usually non-recurring in nature. Capital items are different from revenue items in the sense that they include huge amount of receipts and payments which a non-profit making concern receives or pays in an accounting period. Capital items concerned with the payment for assets and receipts from the owners and outsiders. It is the item of the balance sheet. It is of long-term nature and its benefit is long-lasting. Capital items are further divided into capital receipts and capital expenditures. Capital receipts are the amount of money received by a non-profit making organization in an accounting year, namely legacies, amount received on sale of land and building, furniture and fixtures, donations received, specific funds, etc. Capital expenditure includes costs incurred on the acquisition of a fixed assets, delivery costs, installation costs, replacement costs, etc., and any subsequent expenditure incurred for the extension of the existing fixed asset. Revenue items. A non-trading concern also comes across several items which are repetitive throughout the accounting period. Such recurring items are known as revenue items. These items are short-term in nature and their benefit is quite brief. Revenue items are classified into revenue receipts and revenue expenditures. Revenue receipts. Revenue receipts are the amount of money received by a non-profit concern from time to time within an accounting period. Receipts like subscriptions received, general donations, entrance fee receipts, etc. are termed as revenue receipts. Revenue expenditure. Revenue expenditure incurred on a regular basis and the benefit from these costs is obtained over a relatively short period of time. For example, salaries paid, rent paid, honorarium paid, expenses of events, etc. are termed as revenue expenditure. Number 1. Legacy. Legacy is the sum of money received by the concern as per the will of the donor. It appears on the receipt side of the receipts and payments account. Legacy should not be considered as income but should be treated as capital receipts, that is credited to capital fund account. Number 2. Subscriptions. Subscription is the amount of money received from the members of the concern as per the rules which enable the concern to serve the purpose for which it was created. Subscription appears on the receipt side of the receipts and payments account and is usually credited to income. Care must be exercised to take credit for only those subscriptions which are relevant. Life membership fees. Generally, the members are required to make the payment in a lump sum only once, which enables them to become the members for the whole of the life. Life members are not required to pay the annual membership fees, as life membership fees is a substitute for annual membership fees. Therefore, it is desirable that life membership fees should be credited to a separate fund. Life membership fee should be treated as capital receipt. Entrance fees. This is also an item to be found on the receipts side of the receipts and payments account. There are arguments that it should be treated as capital receipts because entrance fees is to be paid by every member only once, that is when enrolled as member, hence it is non-recurring in nature. But another argument is that since members to be enrolled every year and receipt of entrance fees is a regular item, therefore it should be credited to income. In the absence of the instructions, any of the above treatment may be followed, but students should append to note justifying this treatment. Sale of newspapers, periodicals, etc. As the old newspapers, magazines and periodicals, etc. are to be disposed of every year, the receipts on account of such sale should be treated as income and therefore to be credited to income and expenditure account. Sale of used sports materials. Sale of used sports material is also a regular feature of the clubs. Sale proceeds should be treated as income and therefore to be credited to the income and expenditure account. Honorarium. Persons may be invited to deliver lectures, or artists may be invited by a club to give their performance for its members, and any money paid to such invitees is termed as honorarium. Such honorarium represents expenditure and will be debited to the income and expenditure account. Sale of old asset. Sale of an old asset is a non-recurring item. It cannot be taken to income and expenditure account. It leads to reduction in assets. Therefore, it is shown by a way of deduction from the concerned asset. It is important to note that it is the book value that is to be deducted from assets. Profit or loss on sale is to be transferred to income and expenditure account. Where the book value of asset is nil, the entire proceeds of sale should be treated as income. Specific donations. These are received for specific purposes. For example, donation for building, donation for prizes, donation for construction of pavilion, etc. These are capital receipts and shown on liabilities side. It is worthy to note that such donations should not be treated as income because such donations appear on the liability side because they create a long-term obligation on the institution. For example, a donor may wish that prizes may be awarded year after year out of the income earned on his donations. Such a donation account can't be closed within a year by transferring to income and expenditure account. General donations. A donation received but not for any specific purpose is called the general donation. In case the donation is of a substantial amount, it can be fairly taken for granted that such donation is of a non-recurring nature, and therefore they are to be shown on the liability side of the balance sheet. And if the amount of these donations is lesser, they are to be treated as income and are shown on the income side of the income and expenditure account. Endowment fund. It represents donations for a specific purpose. Here, the objective of the donor is to provide a source of permanent income to the institution. Thus, it is shown in the liability side of the balance sheet. Any income earned during the year in such fund is added to it, and any expenditure incurred during the year is deducted from it. Proceeds of concerts, lectures and dramas or cultural shows. Concerts and lectures of eminent personalities are arranged in aid of charitable trusts. Accounts of non-trading institutions. Amount collected from shows by sale of tickets is an income for the concern and to be shown in the income side of the income and expenditure account. Government grants. Government grants are the grants received from the governments for certain purposes. These grants are of two types. Number one, maintenance grants. The maintenance grants are for meeting routine and recurring expenses. These are treated as income and shown in the income side of income and expenditure account. Number two, development grants. The development grant is for acquiring assets and other equipments. It is treated as capital receipt and to be recorded on the liability side of the balance sheet. Capital fund. In profit making organization, the money required for its activities is called capital, while in case of non-profit organizations, it is known by various names such as capital fund or accumulated funds. It represents the surplus of assets over outside liabilities of the organization. It is usually made up by special donations, legacies, capitalization of admission fees, life membership fees, etc. Capital fund is increased when there is any surplus in the income and expenditure account or decreased by any deficit which arises from income and expenditure account. Deferred revenue expenditure. Deferred revenue expenditure is the expenditure incurred for which the amount of expenditure is carried forward on an assumption that the expenditure will be beneficial over the subsequent period of time. For example, huge amount paid towards special advertising campaigns, heavy losses incurred due to the unforeseen accidents, etc. To sum up, non-trading concerns or non-profit organizations are established for the purpose of rendering services to its members or public at large. They are not expected to earn profit but organized mainly for social, educational, religious or charitable purposes. They do not usually have credit transactions. Even a non-trading concern is required to prepare and maintain certain books of accounts like receipts and payments account, income and expenditure account, and a balance sheet at the end of an accounting period for the purpose of determining the financial position of the concern for the benefits of its members. Receipts and payments account differs from income and expenditure account on various grounds. A non-profit organization may prepare balance sheet in two situations at the beginning of the year to know the capital account and at the end of the year to know the closing balance of capital fund. The transactions of a non-profit organization are divided into capital revenue items. Capital items are the one which do not occur regularly throughout the accounting period. Capital items may be capital receipts and capital payments. On the other hand, items which are recurring throughout the accounting period are known as revenue items. They may be revenue receipts or revenue payments. There are important items to be learned. They are legacies, which are the sum of money received as per the will of a donor. Subscriptions are the money received by a concern from its members for serving the members. Life membership fees are one-time payments and entrance fees are collected regularly. A non-profit concern may receive donations either for general or for specific purpose. Honorarium is the money paid to the persons who have been invited for educational upgradation or entertainment of a non-profit making concerns members. Endowment funds serve as a long-term source of income for the specific purpose. A capital fund is maintained by a non-profit making organization, which are usually made up by special donations, legacies, capitalization of admission fees, life membership fees, etc. Capital fund may fluctuate from year to year. Capital fund is increased when there is any surplus in the income and expenditure account or decreased by any deficit which arises from income and expenditure account.